Hello guys, my name is Ashish and welcome to the Angular series for beginners. In the previous lecture, we have discussed about the event binding and how to use it in the Angular-based project. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss about the class binding with a proper example in Angular. So guys, before starting the lecture, I request you all to subscribe the AxeAdmin channel to get notification whenever a new lecture is uploaded. And guys, please hit the like button at the end so that it will encourage me to bring more awesome lectures for you guys. So guys, let's start with the class binding in Angular. Class binding is used to set a class property of a view element. It is used to set a class property of a view element. We can add or remove the CSS class name from an element class attribute with a class binding. So guys, the class binding syntax is also like the property binding. It is same like the property binding. In the property binding, we only specify the element between the brackets, but in case of the class binding, it starts with the prefix class followed by a dot and the name of the class. So guys, you can bind the class values with the CSS name like class dot class name, and the syntax is, guys, inside the square bracket you have to write class dot class name equals to the variable name which contains the boolean type variable which has the true or the false value. Okay guys, so guys it's easy to bind a CSS class to the element in your Angular template. You provide a class name with a class dot class name between the brackets in your template, and then an expression on the right side that should evaluate to true or false to determine if the class should be applied or not. So guys, inside the class binding you have to write class dot class name inside the square bracket, and then inside the right hand side you have to write the variable name, the boolean variable name which contains the true and false value which determine if the class should be applied or not. Okay guys, so guys next we are going to see an example of the class binding, and we are going to see how to use the class binding in our Angular. Okay guys, So let's move to the project and the program, and let's see how to implement class binding. So guys, here you can see this is our view of our the project Angular. Okay guys, so next what we are so guys in this example we are going to handle the class property using the condition, right guys? So guys for that I am going to create a button. So guys, before that I am putting some br to give space, right? After that guys, I am going to slash a div. Okay, inside div I am going to create a button. Okay, button has a class of a bootstrap button danger, right guys? Danger. And the next guys I am going so guys, next let's keep the button name as a class binding, right? So guys, compile and let's see in the browser. So guys, we can see that there is a button with a name, the class binding, right guys? So guys in the next what we have to do, guys, next we have to imply the CSS. So guys, for that we are going to use the class bindings here. So guys, inside a square bracket you have to write class dot class name. So guys, class name is going is here is like a disable I'm going to use, right? So next is equals to the variable name. So guys is disable, is class disable. Let's keep the variable name is class disabled. Okay, and guys, in the same way we have to assign this variable inside the ts file. So guys, I'm going to the app component.ts. inside the app component.ts I'm going to declare this variable as a boolean type, and guys, the default value of the boolean is false. So guys, let's keep this as a false only, and now we are going to compile the file and we are going to the browser and we are going to see the output. As so guys, we can see that class binding, inside the class binding it is false because okay guys. So guys, next what I am going to do, I am going to do assign is class disable as true. Okay guys, so now the true. So guys, now we can see the output as so guys now it has been not disabled yet. I think there is some error. Let's go and check. This is disabled class boolean is true, and inside is class disabled button danger class dot disabled. Okay guys, here we can see that there is a error in the spelling disabled, right guys? This disabled, I think now it is fine and it should work. So guys, here is class disabled is like true here, so it should disable the button. So guys, here we can see that it is disabling this button. So guys, we can see in the element that disable class has been added, right? Now let's go again and do this as a false. So now again I am going to keep this as a false, and we are going to see that the class has been vanished, right? So now guys, we can see that it is enabled and the disabled class has been vanished from here. So guys, this is an example of the class binding. Here we are okay guys, so next what I am going to do, so guys next we are going to explore this class binding. So next let's put some br here, and let's put one div. Inside div I am creating one more button, right? One more button, and assigning this class with a bootstrap class btn. Now I am keeping as a primary, and now in the same way we have to use a square bracket inside the square bracket class dot and the class name. So guys, now I am going to use the class name as the active, right? And then we have to assign a boolean type variable. So is class active is my variable name, and I am going to keep the name of a button as a class binding active, right? So guys, we can compile and we can see that button has been created in our browser. Okay guys, so here we can see a class binding active button has been created. So guys next what we have to do, so guys, next I am going to declare this variable inside the TS file. Okay guys, in the same way, so guys, this is a boolean type, right? Boolean, and we are going to assign as is class active as true. Okay guys, so guys, we can see active as true, and now I am compiling this and we are going to see in the output. So guys, we can see that this is something like dark. Okay guys, so for that we have to, so guys, here we can see an active class has been added here, right guys? And this is up a little bit dark color, right? So next what we have to do, so guys, next I am going to keep it as a false. So guys, I am removing this active, and now I am going to keep it as a false. So guys, after keeping this is false, is class active is false. So guys, here is class active is false. So guys, class dot active becomes false. So guys, here, so guys, inside the browser we can see that it is no more active now. So guys, we can see inside the element that active has been removed, right guys? Here we can see that active class has been removed. Okay guys, so guys this is an example of the class binding. So guys, for the class binding we have to write the class dot class name inside a square bracket, and then the variable of the boolean type, okay guys, which contains true and false, guys. Okay guys, So guys, I hope I am able to build your concept on the class binding. Okay guys, so guys, in the next lecture we are going to see what is the style binding in Angular. So guys, stay tuned and happy learning. Okay guys, thank you.